Where's Adventure Time? Oh, oh. Почёт, товарищ! My name is Taturo, welcome to the Taturo Place, welcome back to Dreamfall, the longest journey, and this is episode number 3. We're here, it's new chapter, it's winter. Alright, let's get to this house. Sarko, that's you, darling? Find April, save April!
Find her, save her. You must find her. You must save her.
I don't understand. Please, what do you want with me?
Find April Ryan. Hurry, Zoe, hurry.
But what do...
You must hurry. Go. Now.
Jimmy, I must. Are you gonna pay me? Are you gonna give me a present? Jimmy, I must. I must do nothing if it's for free.
Ryan, save her.
Well, maybe only for April Ryan. Alright, Winter. Alright, Faith. Alright, Zoe. Am I wearing a sweater now since it's cold? Cold weather, I don't care. Oh. This is like some kind of temple. Underground temple.
Where the hell am I? This is not real. This cannot be real. I need to wake up. Or get out of here. I need to do something. Anything.
Are these creatures dangerous though? This is my question. I'm getting some pebbles. Just for fun, you know. What should I do?
What a strange creature. I've never seen anything like it.
Yeah. Is it gonna attack me? Scheiße! Is your name Scheiße? Get away from me! Where's the witch? He lost me. He's stupid. Is he gonna stay there? Can I go? Let's go. He's stupid. Or maybe he's just glitching. This is closed. Yeah, I'll just take it, because why not? It's a glowing egg. It looks pretty. Maybe it's expensive. Alright, so it'll save. Well, that was kinda... crazy. Like, I did not expect this creature following me. I wonder, was I supposed to, like, distract them or something with the pebbles? I probably should put the egg.
It looks like a machine with a big wheel and a socket on top. I wonder what it does, and if it still works.
Well, let's try it out.
It's definitely mechanical, and old. Who built these things?
The creatures. Yes, Zoe. Look at her leather pants. She's fancy. Right, let it be water.
That's like watermill. She's like, what the hell am I supposed to do now? Okay, Zoe. Let's go. I mean, it looks pretty. Look at these creatures on the well. Most likely I have to climb or do something. Let's see. Yeah, just like that. You know what? I think I should have taken the egg with me. I think I should have taken the egg with me, guys. Let me get down. Let me get down. Go up, go down, down, down. Everything for the crown, crown, crown. Thank you. Can I climb up? Nope. Okay. Whatever you say, Zoe. And the sound, it was like pom 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 pom. So it's like pom 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 pom. Okay. Whoop. Alright, athletic. Well, we're getting out, hopefully. I like this egg. I need it in my house to like use it instead of electricity, you know? Or maybe I should just live in this place. Look, what a pretty bat. Everything's nice and cute.
Those glowing symbols look like they're etched right into the rock.
Okay, so I think it was pom, pom. No, 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 no. Pom, 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 pom. Pom, 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 pom. No, 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 no. I was correct first time when I thought that it was like pom 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 pom. Here you go, guys. She's like so chill about all the magical portals. Oh. Sheesh. Like torturing.
It's locked from the outside.
Let's unlock it. In your face, door. In your face. Strong woman and strong.
That machine looks brand new. It definitely doesn't fit in with the rest of the stuff down here. All this stuff, it's like something out of a fantasy role-playing game. Who stores food like this? I don't think I'm in Newport anymore.
Oh. That's Journeyman. That's Journeyman, guys. Oh my mama, oh my mama, where's the comfy chair? Benry Mesalman! What's poppin', Benry man?
That beer tap looks out of place. It's too shiny and modern.
Yeah, Azadi.
Benrima, visitor.
What are you on about, Bryn?
She's standing right next to you.
Hello?
Oh, blessed be the sixth child, you startled me.
You speak English? Oh, thank God. Listen, I'm not sure what's happened.
Speak what? Who are you? Where do you come from?
I don't know. I think I'm dreaming.
On the moon, it's I'm a dreamer, dreamer.
No matter what I do, I can't seem to wake up.
Dream? This is no dream, child. Do you need me to pinch your arm?
What? No. No, that's... I'm... The twins, they did something to me. Something...
How did you get in? We don't open until midday.
Open what?
The inn, child. What do you think? Are you soft-witted, or... By the balance, you're from the other side, aren't you?
What?
Gracious me. Another shifter. Why do they always end up here?
Another what?
You must go see Minstrel Magda immediately. She will explain everything.
Minstrel Magda?
Leave now, but be cautious, and don't speak a word of this to anyone. They have ears everywhere.
Look, I don't know what's going on, and I don't know what a shifter is, or why I'm supposed to see this Magda person, and...
I understand that you are frightened, child.
You don't understand. I have absolutely no idea what's going on. I'm almost starting to think that those stories Charlie told me about April Ryan are true.
Did you say April Ryan?
Yeah. Do you know her?
No, I don't recognize the name. You need to see Minstrel Magda, child.
I guess I don't have a choice, dream or no dream. Where can I find her?
She moves around, but Blind Bob ought to know where she is. He's right outside. You can't miss him.
Blind Bob, Minstrel Magda, underground cities and strange monsters. I feel like I'm inside some kind of fairy tale. Or
Benrima Salmon, child. I'm the innkeeper of the Journeyman Inn. If you ever need anything... Come see me. I'll help you the best I can.
I'm Zoe, and thank you. I'm sure I will see you again. You're the only person I know in this place.
Okay, guys, I accidentally skipped one line. I'm sorry about that. But I believe it's nothing too important.
Unlike most things in this place, that fireplace feels comfortably familiar.
Oh, yes. Oh, we cannot get inside. Okay. Okay, let's find Blind Bob. Journeyman, guys! All these locations, Jesus Christ. So beautiful.
Poor old dying bastard.
Can I talk?
I need to get this book returned to the library, but they've closed off Coldstone Gate for security reasons. Oh my.
Okay.
Arms for a poor old blind bastard with no home, no hearth.
I'm so sorry, I don't have any money.
Ah, well, I'll let you in on a secret, Rose Petal. Blind Bob's happy you don't have no home, no hearth. Had those, hated them, left to begin a career in beggaring. Now a pauper's life is a king's life. Freedom, fresh air, no strings, no stress, no bleeding taxes.
Aren't you cold?
You'd think, but no. Had a bit of an accident with a fire charm when I was a wee lad. Left me permanently temperate. It's actually quite pleasant.
But what about that whole being blind thing? That can't be good.
Oh, that. It's theoretical.
Theoretical?
I could have been blind. Had an accident with a chemical spell when I was a wee lad. Near burned me eyes out.
But it didn't.
No, not at all. Missed Blind Bob's face by a mile. Could have burned me eyes out, mind you. Could very well have. So I'm theoretically blind. Of course, theoretically blind Bob is no proper name for a beggar. So I just use Blind Bob nowadays. That's me, that is.
Okay. Hello.
Help.
Can I ask you a question?
You can ask. I might answer, I might not.
Fair enough. I'm looking for someone. The innkeeper said you might know. Her name is...
Hold it right there, Rose Petal. Tit for tat. Them's the rules.
What do you mean?
If you want Blind Bob to do you a favor, you do him one first.
Nope. I'm not in the mood for this. Or do I have a choice? Okay, I'm not in the mood for this. I'm sorry.
Look, I'm only asking for information. Nothing else.
Well, see, information's all Blind Bob's got, Rose Petal. It's his only, what's that name? Commode.
Don't you mean commodity?
No, commode. Information's where I keep my valuables, see?
Oh. Well, I don't have anything to trade for. No money, no information, nothing.
A sweet rose like you got nothing to trade for? I beg to differ, Petal. For starters, you seem to be chummy with Benrime, the innkeeper.
I just met her.
Even so, you might be able to pry her cold, miserly fingers off a boiling hot bottle of mulled wine. Blind Bob would be mighty grateful for that, he would. Ha!
Mulled wine? That's what you want?
Oh, nothing would taste sweeter right now. Get Blind Bob a bottle of mulled wine, Petal, and he'll open his mouth right wide, you'll see. Mind, it's made with Mrs. Mullins' mixed spices. Anything else is a waste of hot wine.
Oh so cool, my so god, so guys, here we go, quests. Here we go, quests. It's interesting to see Arcadia in winter time. Where's Benrime?
Hello?
Yes? Oh, it's you. What can I do for you, child?
Wine.
I spoke with Blind Bob, but he wouldn't tell me anything.
Ah, yes. Tit for tat. Given a chance to bargain, Blind Bob will take it. What does he want now?
Mulled wine. He wants mulled wine made with, Mrs. something or other spice mix.
Mrs. Mullins mixed spices. For a beggar, Blind Bob is quite particular.
I don't know what to do. If I can't find Minstrel Magda, I can't get home. If I can't get home...
Calm down, child. I will help the best I can. I have red wine and I can heat it up for you, but I'm all out of spices. I was supposed to receive a delivery this morning, but no one has been by yet, and I cannot leave the inn to get them myself.
Maybe I could pick up the spices for you.
For sure.
You could. I buy my spices from a merchant at the Southgate Market. His is the first stall on the left when you walk down Irede Avenue. Just tell him Benrime sent you to pick up her order of Mrs. Mullins' mixed spices. And be sure to mention that I'm not happy he did not make his delivery as scheduled. I will put some wine on the boil while you are away.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome, child. Run along now.
Wait, how do I get to the market?
The quickest way would be through Old Town, but they've closed it off this morning. You'll have to go the long way around. Walk east, towards the tower. When you get to the tower square, go south. That will take you onto Irede Avenue, which leads all the way down to the south gate.
East, then south. Okay, thank you.
Alright, let's go. Let's get him. Because why not, right? First quest of the day. Let's slay.
Don't mind me, good sir, madam.
First east, then right. Then south. Okay, let's go. What is this camp? Are these refugees or something? Oh, that's the Minstrom's tower, right? The one when we were was April, when she first popped in the Arcadia city world. Okay, I probably should not go there. Sup, boy?
The construction of our glorious tower will soon be complete.
Okay. Excuse me? Excuse me?
You can say what you will about the Azadi, but they are skilled builders.
Okay, Grandma. Azadi. So, apparently somebody conquered the city or something? This looks different. There's all these machines. The salty seaman. Sailor supplies. Is this the trader that I need? Trader Joe, hello. That you?
Hello, hello. Oh, what a wonderful morning we're having. How may I be of service today, young lady?
The innkeeper at the Journeyman sent me to pick up an order of Mrs. Mullins' mixed spices. It's for...
mulled wine. Yes. Oh, Benrime boils the best cauldron in town, she does. Absolutely wonderful. I'll have them sent right up. Fantastic. Next.
Hold on. Benrime needs the spices right now. You could just give them to me and I'll deliver them for you.
Why, yes. Yes, I could give the spices to you. What a wonderful idea. Saves me from having to deliver them, doesn't it? Fantastic. No problem. None at all. Except...
except what?
I don't know you.
There's a tiny, tiny problem. Nothing major. Nothing that can't be solved. Why, it's barely worth mentioning.
What is this?
You see, the thing is, I don't actually have any spices at all this morning.
I see. Isn't this the spice store? Benrime told me to go to the spice store.
Well, then you've certainly come to the right place. I sell spices and little else. In fact, I'm the exclusive distributor of Mrs. Mullins in Mercuria. Best spice mixers in the Northlands, or any lands. It's just that, well, my delivery is a tiny bit delayed this morning.
Really? How delayed?
Oh, I'm sure it'll be here any... quite a bit, to be honest with you. Quite a bit.
I need it right now, boy.
How delayed is quite a bit?
I'm sure it won't take more than a few hours.
Excuse me?
A few hours, at most. Before lunchtime, I'm sure. Or by tea time. If he's not here by dinner time, I'll eat my left shoe.
I really do need those spices. Like, now.
I wish I could be of more help, young lady. But as long as the ghetto's closed, the carriages are stuck in Burrow Crook.
The ghetto?
Oh, you're an out-of-towner. Welcome to Mercuria, etc., etc. Wonderful, wonderful.
So what about the ghetto?
Right. Well, the Azadi have set aside a section of Old Town for the Magicals. That way they can be with their own. We don't bother them, they don't bother us. Fantastic. Wonderful.
Why can't the carriages come through?
Well, once in a while, the Azadi help the Magicals weed out undesirables. They close the ghetto down, search the buildings for criminals and contraband. Sort of spring cleaning, if you will.
And your supplier is stuck in, what, traffic?
On the other side of the ghetto, up Burrow Crook, towards Coalstone Gate. Why, right below the Journeyman.
I just came from there.
Right, so you... Wait. Why don't we help each other out, eh? If you pick up my delivery of Mrs. Mullins' mixed spices, our specialty, and bring them back here, I can give you Benrime's order.
I don't think it's a good idea for me to start running errands.
No. I don't have time to run errands. I'm sorry.
Of course, you have more important things to do. Wonderful. Best of luck to you, young lady.
What about this lady? She has wine?
She's operating a soup kitchen.
Let's see it.
Good morning, dear. You look hungry. Do you want some soup?
Good soup.
All profits go to the refuge. We shelter and feed the homeless and the penniless.
No, thank you. I'm not hungry.
Very well, dear. Come back if you change your mind.
I also don't have money.
You're back. How wonderful it is to see you again so soon.
Reconsider.
I'm here to take you up on your offer.
Fantastic! Wonderful! Wonderful! What offer was that again?
To pick up the spices.
Ah, yes! Wonderful! Fantastic! Your assistance is much appreciated, young lady.
I guess it beats waiting around.
Fantastic! You'll want to speak with Harry Kinram. He's a bearded fellow, a tad ornery, but a decent fellow at heart. He'll be up Burrow Crook, right below the Journeyman Inn. You can't miss him. Ask him for Mrs. Mullins' mixed spices. He'll try and get some money from you, but the order's been paid for already.
Guy with a beard, wagons, Burrow Crook. Okay, I'll try my best.
Come right back here with the spices, and I'll give you Benrime's order. Wonderful. Fantastic.
Boy, why would I come back? Like, if I'm picking the Benrima's mixed spices, whatever it is, I can just go to Benrima and give all this shit to her without even getting back to this guy, right? Girl? Oh my gosh, he's so naive. Anyways, the city looks pretty.
What are we doing with this one?
He was caught inside the ghetto, selling medicine to the magicals.
You know what that is, don't you? Treason.
Treason against the Empire, and Sadir, that'd have your head off.
In a second. Any humans who get involved with the magicals are traitors to their race.
That might not warrant an appointment with the Blade here in this goddessless city, but we'll find a way to get you shipped off to Sadir. Move it!
Why he's standing like this, though? So fierce. Oh, they disappeared. Okay, the question is, why Linus is itching is the first question. The second question, what is unmagical people? I thought everyone in Arcadia are magicians or whatever, and these guys, they apparently know magical people. Okay, that's weird.
Don't mind me, good sir, madam. I'm just a poor old...
What's up? Oh, still with a book. Here's the guy with the spices. He looks nasty a little bit. There's the caravan. Really hope he won't ask me to do anything else for him. Just give me the freaking spices, that's it, boy.
The traffic appears to be backed up.
May the six grant me strength. As if this morning hasn't been trying enough. And what do you want, girl? On second thought, don't tell me. I'm not in the mood for idle chatter.
But I...
Magicals? Damn ghetto rats. And those rebels. More like terrorists, if you ask me. Not a day goes by without them troublemakers making trouble for the rest of us. They should stick them on a boat and send them out to sea so as they don't bother honest humans trying to make an honest living. Call themselves freedom fighters, the terrorists do. But it's because of them that I'm stuck here. Again! Freedom! Freedom for who? From what? It's not like the Azadi are keeping us imprisoned. In fact, life's a damn sight better than it was before they came. If this is oppression, I don't want to be liberated.
Listen, I...
Ye gods! I mean goddess! There's only one. Blessed be her name, etc.
You are so annoying. Listen to me. I just spoke with the spice merchant at the Southgate Market.
You'll have to wait until they reopen the ghetto, just like everyone else.
Well, he sent me to pick up a delivery of, Mrs. Mullen's mixed spices.
What? No, that's, all right. It's irregular, but I reckon I can part with it for a fair price.
He said it's been paid for already, and that you'd probably try to weasel more money out of me.
For the love of... I'll just tell him we'll sort it out when I get down there. Mind you, it could take a while. Doesn't look like they're reopening the ghetto anytime soon.
I'm sorry, but he said he needs the spices right away. He's out of stock.
I keep hearing this buzzing sound in my ear, but I don't see any black flies around. Only you.
You can ignore me all you want, but I'm not leaving. If you think you're having a bad day, you should try mine on for size.
By the Mojals. I mean, by the grace of the six, blessed be their names. If you'll leave me be, I'll give you the bloody spices. And now, for the love of the goddess and for the sake of my sanity, let me be miserable in peace.
Absolutely. Won't bother you again. Thank you.
Alright, that's good. So was this like Irish accent? This is my favorite accent ever. Wish I could do that. Wish I could speak like that. I cannot even try, because I would sound freaking silly. Okay, here the spices are. I really don't want to bring it back to...
Hello?
That guy. Spices, what's English?
How come everyone speaks English here?
English? No, child. We speak all tongue, as do you.
Or what?
All tongue. Naven, it is the common tongue of our world.
But we're speaking English now, right?
No. Naven is a magical tongue. It is learned quickly by those who know how to listen.
Really? So, what? I can speak a magical language? That's incredible.
Incredible? No, it is quite ordinary, child.
That's funny.
It wasn't easy, but I got the spices.
It took you long enough, child. Did you get lost?
No, but I had to do a lot of running around. It doesn't matter. I have the spices now.
Good. There's a pot of red wine in the kitchen. Mix the spices in, let it boil for a while, and you have mulled wine.
Thank you so much. I appreciate all your help.
Well, you look like you need all the help I can give you, child.
Thank you, Benrime. Red wine, come the gaga.
I've added Mrs. Mullins' mixed spices to the wine. That should be it then. I've added Mrs. Mullins' mixed spices to the wine. That should be it then.
How do I take it?
I've added Mrs. Mullins' mixed spices to the wine.
Oh, there was a cup.
That should be it then. Mulled wine.
I didn't see the cup. I'm sorry, besties. And I think we got all the freaking spices. Nothing left for that other guy, the trader guy. Well, I'm sorry. Whatever. I have my business here, so...
Alms! Alms for a poor old blind bastard!
Here. Mulled wine made with Mrs. Mullins' mixed spices.
Ah, the sweet scent of Mrs. Mullins and Riverwood Red. Give it here, Petal. Let me take a swig.
He's gonna be drunk, huh? Hopefully he'll still be able to help us.
Ah, by the balance that hit the spot it did. Ah, I'm most grateful, Petal. You've earned yourself a silver star in Blind Bob's book.
Why not gold?
Glad you liked it. It wasn't easy getting it.
Without the journey, the reward isn't half as sweet. That's, what's her name? Old Chestnut round these parts. Still as true as the sky is green.
Green?
Had an accident with a chroma charm when I was a wee lad. Every morning Blind Bob wakes up, the sky's a different colour. Today it's green.
Hey, but what's up?
Hi there.
Alms for a poor... Oh, ha! It's ye. What tidings of joy do you bring me this time?
Magda, baby.
Do you know where I can find Minstrel Magda?
Oh, he knows her, Blind Bob does. He knows her well. Nice lady. Best sort nut soup south of Lame Bastard Hill.
Do you know where she is today?
Oh, she moves around, Magda does. Ain't seen her round here in a while. You might try asking someone other than Blind Bob.
Like who? I don't know anyone in the city.
Well, you might have more luck asking Crazy Clara. Lives up Crab Bend, Clara does, on Hangman's Span, in view of Friar's Keep. Crazy as a turnip, Clara is. But she's also got a scout wing's eyes. She knows more than she lets on.
Where can I find this Crazy Clara again?
Oh, okay. Well...
Thank you.
I mean, apparently...
So cold,
he
so
was
so
bullshitting me. I got him this wine for what? For him to send me to some other person? Really? Oh, right. That's not how it works. Whatever you give life, you will get back. Why be a wallflower when you can be a Venus flytrap? Why this lady is always walking this way? She's chilling with the Zaddy guys. Alright, Grandma. Grandma knows what's up. Salty Seaman. Okay.
Spices! We've got spices!
Hopefully he won't talk to me. Yeah, I'm sorry, my man. Should we talk?
Hello, hello, hello! What a beautiful morning! Fantastic! Did you find my man? And the spices? Did you get the spices?
Lie, truth. Make up an excuse.
Yes, I did get the spices.
Oh, fantastic! Wonderful! Great news! Now I can get back to business. I've had to turn customers away all morning.
Yeah, that's good. Only I don't have the spices anymore.
What? What happened? You didn't get mugged, did you? Did you get mugged? Who am I?
No, I didn't get mugged. I just... I don't have the spices anymore.
I see. Okay. Deep breath. It's not a problem. Everything's fine. I'm sure there's a perfectly good explanation.
We can work around this. I'm sure.
There's no working around this one, I'm afraid. The spices are gone.
Right. Excellent. Small problem. Nothing major. Just a minor bump in the road. I'll be back on my feet in no time.
Yeah. I'm sure you will. Sorry, have to run. Bit of a hurry. Bye now.
Yes, things will probably pick up again. Except my customers will head elsewhere if I don't. Not to worry. I'm sure I can delay paying rent on the store for a few more days. The Azadi are probably quite reasonable, I would think. Quite reasonable. Yes. Wonderful.
Okay, I feel bad now about that, but why couldn't she bring back the rest of the spices? That's my question. Okay, let's find Clara. Oh, Clara, that she was popping.
Hi there. Are you are you Clara by any chance?
You've been a bad girl, Clara. You'll have to be punished. My baby. Gone.
What?
I'm looking for Minstrom Magda.
The Minstrom are evil, Clara. They cloud your mind with their spiritual claptrap. My baby is gone.
Oh my gosh, what is the baby?
You wouldn't happen to know where Magda is, would you?
All gone.
Right. There's no chance you'll turn uncrazy for a moment and answer my question, is there?
Gone.
Bitch.
I didn't think so. No. So, you lost something? Or someone?
My baby.
Yes, that part I got. Your baby. Is it a child? A pet?
Westerlings caught him in a net, just like a butterfly. That's illegal, that is. Can't have that now, can we? Boxed him right up. We'll take care of him, put him to sleep for you. Pretty thing. Poor thing, my baby.
So it is your pet. A dog? Cat? I'm guessing there are stranger pets in this world.
No stranger. Best friend. You'll never have friends. You've been bad. No, please, no. My friend.
You said the Westerlings took him. Who are the Westerlings?
The ghetto's Klaus. Stand back. What's that you've got there, eh? Give us that thing right now.
The soldiers took him. What did they do with him?
We'll take care of him, we will. Gone. But close. So close. I still hear him, my baby. I still hear him crying.
Do you want me to help you find your baby?
Find baby?
Yes, if I can. I'll try. Do you know where he is?
Caged up like the twinkles in a diamond. He was coming home to Mammy. Home. Never again. Never.
Don't say that. We'll find him, okay?
Oh, poor Clara. I think she said something about ghetto, so let's go to ghetto. I'm pretty sure she won't help me to find Magda, though. Look, she's like insanely crazy. Like cray-cray. Abso-freaking-lutely. I think I'm using word freaking too much, but I'm just using it instead of fucking. I wanna look at this pretty window. Madame Emiliana.
Hey, you can't go in there.
What's in there? Do you mean I can't? Well, I can.
That must be Crazy Clara's pet. It's really cute.
Hi, babe. It's beautiful. Uh-oh. As soon as I'm here, in a new place, I'm bringing destruction, huh?
Fish.
Yeah.
My father and I are visiting Mercuria for the day. We live up north, in the farmlands west of the forest. It's not often that I get to see the city.
Yeah, Mercuria looks a little bit nasty nowadays. It was like flourishing, prosperous town before in the first game, but now it's all kind of wild because all these Azadi guys. Alright, Clara should be happy now. What's poppin'? Where's Magda, babe?
I see you got your baby back.
Safe now. You're happy. So, so happy.
I'm glad. Look, I'm trying to find Minstrel Magda. Do you know where she is?
Magda? Where is Magda?
That's what I need to know. Please, could you try and focus for a second? I really need to find Minstrel Magda.
Cup of soup, Clara? Says the soup lady. Oh, yes, please. Right you are, then. Mmm, salt nut soup, our favourite.
What do you mean? Oh, soup lady, as in soup kitchen. She runs a soup kitchen.
Soup. Soup for the poor and homeless, warm and thick with peas and carrots in it. And not only peas and carrots, but dubious lumps too.
Where is Magda's soup kitchen?
I go down there every morning to have my soup. I do. She's nice, she is. The soup lady. You ask her nicely, I'm sure she'll give you a cup too.
Down where? The market?
We're just down the street, Clara, at the Southgate Market from sunrise till midday every day. You come by any time, you hear?
That's right. The soup kitchen. I pass right by it. Thanks, Clara. Take good care of your baby, okay? He's a beautiful pet.
Wave goodbye now. Wave goodbye, little one.
Yeah, it's so cute. I don't even know what this creature is, but it's so cute. And we already spoke to Soup Lady. So we already spoke to Soup, to Minstrel Magda. Okay. Alright, Magda, I see you.
Hello again, dear. Did you change your mind? Would you like a cup of soup?
Magda?
No, thank you. Are you Minstrel Magda?
Shh, not so loud. There are ears everywhere. Who are you? What do you want?
Oh. I'm just looking for Minstrel Magda.
I don't know any Minstrel Magda. There are no Minstrel in this city. Not anymore.
But I was told that you... That Minstrel...
Like I said, there are none left.
I didn't know that. I don't know anything. I was just told that... That Magda could help me.
And who, pray tell, told you that?
Innkeeper Crazy Clara Blind Bob Innkeeper.
The innkeeper at the Journeyman.
Oh? And who would that be?
Benrime Salmin.
Her name is Benrime Salmin.
I see. So Benrime sent you to find Magda. Now why would she do a thing like that?
Because I'm not from around here.
That much is quite obvious. Very well, dear. I do believe that you're as lost as you seem to be. I'm Magda. Just Magda, mind, and you would do well to address me as such. Either that or
ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
No titles, no honorifics. Benrime ought to have made that clear to you. I will try and assist you with any questions that you may have, and maybe even point you in the right direction. But be discreet. Like I said, there are ears everywhere.
Help.
Why did the innkeeper tell me to see you?
Most likely because I have assisted travelers like you before. But the times have changed. Mercuria has become a very dangerous place for people like yourself. For me too, but I belong here. You do not.
You think? I just want to go home.
And so you should, with haste. There's no adventure to be had here. Not anymore.
So there's nothing you can do for me?
Like I said, I will assist you with any questions you may have, and I will point you in the right direction.
Well, bitch,
but
point.
That is all I can do.
Mm.
Do you know anyone by the name of April Ryan?
April? I may have heard that name before.
What would you with her?
I don't know. I need to find her.
Save her.
We have something in common, and I think she's in trouble.
And you intend to save her? How do you propose to do that?
I don't know that either. I just need to find her.
And save her.
Well, I apologize, but I cannot help you there.
What?
Can you help me get back to my world?
No, I cannot. It's too dangerous. But I can point you in the direction of someone who might be able to help you.
Come on.
You will need to enter Old Town. They call it the Magic Ghetto these days, after our protectors rebuilt the wall. The entrance to the ghetto is across the square. The gate is usually open, but right now the soldiers are conducting a raid. You will have to wait until they open the gates again.
Where do I go once I'm on the inside?
Seek out an artisan of the magic craft. Their skills have been mostly outlawed by the Azadi, except inside the ghetto. A practitioner of the craft might be able to help you draw on your latent talents to open a gateway. But be careful. If the Azadi were to learn of your origins and powers, they would show no mercy. You would be sent away to stand trial. They fear magic, these foreigners. They are doing their best to control it, and everyone who uses it. And I fear they may be succeeding in their endeavors. Like I said, you would stand a better chance of getting home if you visited Old Town.
Gotcha, thank you.
Thank you.
You watch yourself out there. Don't get in the way of the Azadi soldiers. If they knew whence you came.
I'll be careful. Bye.
Psst. Hey. Hey.
Bryn. Bryn, I love his eyes. So blue and beautiful. Okay.
What do you want?
I hear you're looking for a way into the ghetto.
Who told you... Oh, wait. Weren't you at the inn this morning?
Not here. There are soldiers around. Follow me.
I'm not following you anywhere.
But I can show you a way into the ghetto.
Just hold on a minute. Who are you?
My name is... It's Worm.
It?
Worm? That doesn't exactly inspire trust.
What are you talking about?
How do I know I can trust you?
Back at the inn, I heard you say the name... April Ryan.
You know her?
I may know how to get in touch with her.
You do? How?
You'll just have to trust me.
If you overheard me talking to the innkeeper, you know I'm not from around here. I can't just follow any stranger I meet on the street. I mean, how do I know you won't lead me into a dark alley, knock me out, tie me up and drag me into a basement somewhere?
I promise I won't drag you into a basement. Besides, what choice do you have? You're stuck here, aren't you? I'm the only one who can take you to April. She's the one you're looking for, right?
Okay, fine. So I don't have much of a choice. But if you're lying to me, I'll scream. I can scream pretty loud.
I'm sure you can. I promise no basements. Come on.
All right.
Come on. Hurry up. We don't want to stay close.
Maybe we'll finally
be... This is it. We're almost there. It's
able to meet April. The Salty Seaman. Okay. Now.
Now! Careful, Chuan. She's a screamer. Raven will be pleased that we bagged us a spy.
I'm dreaming on the moon, I'm a dreamer, dreamer.
She's a spy.
She does not look Azadi.
Like that matters. You can't tell and you can't trust anyone. Let's get rid of her.
Bryn?
All I'm saying is let's not take any chances. She might have a tracking spell on her for all we know.
I would have detected it. There's something peculiar about her, but no magic.
Peculiar? What did I tell you? She's a spy, all right? Come on, let's get rid of her.
Quiet. I'll speak with her. Alone.
What? Why?
Bryn, don't make me lose my patience with you. You need to trust me.
But I...
Bryn, come.
This is April's voice.
Fine. Fine. But don't say I didn't warn you.
So, why are you asking questions about me?
Where am I? Who are you?
I'm asking the questions here.
Wait, you're April, aren't you? I recognize you from the picture.
What? What picture?
A picture of you and your friends, Charlie and Emma. I was in your old room at the Victor, in the border house in Newport. Charlie told me about you, that you disappeared and that...
Whoa, slow down, slow down. You know Charlie and Emma? How's that even... How are they doing?
I only just met them, at the Fringe, back in my world.
Stark, I'm guessing you're not a spy.
I don't even know how I got here. Last thing I remember, I was at the Fringe. I was going upstairs to make a call, and then... black. When I woke up, I was in this strange place. A subterranean city. And there were these creatures. I had to sneak by them. All the time I was repeating to myself, they can't harm you, it's just a dream. Except
it's no dream. I know the feeling. When I first came here, I refused to believe what my eyes and ears were telling me. But you learn to accept the truth. You have to. You're a shifter. You've traveled through the divide between worlds. You're in Arcadia.
A shifter? That's what Ben Rime and Minstrom Magda told me. What's a shifter?
It'll take too long to explain. You're special. How's that? You can travel between worlds.
Travel? So how do I get back to our world?
Your world, not mine. You just do it. Once you learn how, it's like blinking with your mind.
But I can't even remember how I got here in the first place.
First couple of times, it's hard. It's easier when you're asleep.
I wasn't sleeping. At least, I don't think I was. It's
fuzzy.
I'm sure you'll figure it out. What's your name?
Zoe.
Look, Zoe, I'd let you go, but I don't want you walking around out there asking questions, drawing attention to yourself. We'll have to put you somewhere safe, until you can find your way back to Stark.
No. No, I'm here now, and I need your help.
What? Why?
Something's happening back in the real world, in my world. And I think you're connected to it somehow. I've been... receiving this strange message.
From a ghost.
Like a... I don't know. A vision broadcast through the wire. I keep seeing a snowy landscape with a scary black house that looks like a doll's house. And a little girl. Find April Ryan, she says. Save her. Over and over again.
Receiving? How? Through dreams?
No. No, on screens. It's like some kind of static interference. What does it mean?
Don't ask me. I don't need saving. You've got the wrong woman.
I don't think so. This girl, she led me to your room where I found the picture. It can't be a coincidence.
It can't? You're sure about that? Look, Stark's not my world anymore. You got problems, you figure them out. That's what I had to do. I'm done with the saving of the world. Ask someone else.
But
I'll help you get back. It's either that, or we lock you up somewhere until you figure out how to use your powers.
And what do I tell your friends?
Tell them whatever you want. The April Ryan they knew is dead. I'm not part of their world anymore.
So you're not going to help me? You're not curious to find out why I keep getting these messages about you? What if something big is going down and...
Like I said... Not my problem. I've played my part. Just leave me alone. Now, do you want to go back or not?
I do. Of course I do.
Good. Like I said, if this doesn't work, we'll have to make other arrangements. We're going to put you under hypnosis and unlock the part of your subconscious that controls your shifting powers. Lie down on that bed, and I'll be right back.
So April is 28 right now because it's been 10 years. It's wild.
What are you going to do?
There's a part of you that knows how to travel. I will help you remember what you have not yet learned.
And I'll end up back in Newport.
can't guarantee you that. You might end up somewhere else. Just try and focus on a familiar place. A safe place.
So you're not going to help me?
You don't need my help. Lie still.
What's she talking about?
Something's going on back in our world. A good friend of mine's disappeared and...
And you need to not talk. Or would you rather have me lock you up?
And I think April can help me find out what's happened to him and why. So why won't you?
Because I have enough trouble in my life already. Because I'm fighting a war and because I'm done with your world. Now this is your final chance. Close your eyes. Breathe slowly. Don't speak. Listen to Naane's voice.
Na'a, Amam, Ayan'an. Listen to my voice. Let it carry you into yourself, into the secret places in your mind. Ane'an, Ayan'an, Ayan'an.
I don't feel a thing. What's this supposed to...
What just happened?
I do not know, April'an. She did not open a shift. And her clothes...
They're still here. Where did she go?
I do not know. I have never seen anything like it. It is almost as though she was smoke blown away by a wind.
Is she dead?
I cannot say. I do not feel her here, in this world. But I will say this. I do not think this girl is a shifter.
Then what is she? And where did she go?
So many questions for everyone. Okay. Oh shit, is it? Doesn't look like winter no more. Palm trees in black and white. Alright, boys. What's poppin' here? Oh, about to start fighting. Well, let's go. Show me what you got. Really? Like this, boy? Like this, boy? Show me what you got. Show me what you got, baby. Hey, in your face, bestie. In your face. Oh, shit. Come on. Come on.
Boys might make warriors someday.
All right, bro. Oh. All right, white guy. Ooh. He's doing pretty good. Watch what you're doing, boy. Oh, shit. My fighting system in this game is wild. And the last one. 1, 2, 3, not only you and me. How dare you? Almost there, almost there. Just die already.
You did well, but you can do even better.
That do good. Oh, he's running funny.
Not bad, Kian. You did well out there today.
Thank you, Master, but your praise shames me. The light of the goddess blinds my opponents and guides my sword to victory.
Your skill with the sword is unmatched, Kian, and so is your faith, but the one does not equate with the other.
What do you mean, Master?
Your devotion to your faith and your prowess with a blade should never be confused. Religion and war mix as well as dry grass and a flaming torch.
How can that be? I hold my sword in the name of my faith. And my faith is the shield that protects me from harm. They are like two rings intertwined.
Or like a pair of snakes eating each other's tails. Don't be blinded by rhetoric, Kian. I've taught you better than that.
But the mission, Garmon.
Politics! When did you become a woman? Your dedication to the mission is a waste of your potential and your time. With great talent comes great responsibility. You could be a powerful man, Kian. Instead, you've chosen life as a puppet. A puppet!
Well, you've never approved of my calling, but I have pledged my life to the goddess and I have vowed to protect her word.
The word of the goddess does not require your protection, and you have pledged your life to the Six, not the goddess. Don't confuse the two.
On this, we will never see eye to eye, Master. I am an apostle of the faith, and I have...
1,000 pardons, Apostle.
Excuse me, Master. Yes, Child Anna.
The six require your presence, Apostle.
When?
My apologies, Apostle. They said to bring you immediately.
Thank you. Master, forgive me.
Of course, Kian. You're excused. We will continue practice without you. Amanon! Nozan! Into the ring! And try not to swing your swords like shy little schoolgirls this time around!
Please, Amanon Nozan, I love it. Also, why his accent is Irish again? Is it the same actor? Where do I go? Alright. Chandelier, alright. Kinda pretty. Looks like two planets or something. What am I gonna do,
Apostle,
with all these ladies?
Our apologies for calling you away while you were training.
We know that you are busy with the initiates, but this could not wait.
We have just had word from our armies in the east, and it worries us deeply. Our dearest Apostle, we have a very important task for you.
Yes, Mistress.
Apostle, you know how some Eastlanders still resist our noble efforts at uniting their fractured nations and bringing the word to their goddessless lives. The mission continues unabated, of course. Nothing shall stand between the glory of the goddess and those lost ones who have strayed from her light. But still there are a few who have chosen to oppose us. Those misguided pagans have become a dangerous obstacle in the path.
Apostle Kian, we need you to travel east to those heathen lands to bring the word to the heretics.
There is a man who leads these rebellious few, these insurgents. A man whose hands are soiled with the blood of many trueborn. A daemon.
Daemon?
You must travel tonight to the Havens, Apostle, and board a cloud ship bound for the city of Mercuria. When you reach your destination, you will seek out this man, this butcher. They call him the Scorpion. You must seek him out, and you must convert him.
By the letting of his blood, he shall be reborn into the next life, where he may find forgiveness in the glory of the goddess.
Find this rebel leader, this Scorpion, and let your blade kiss his throat. This is your mission, Kian Alvane.
As you please, Mistress. Your word is my path.
You will leave now with haste. May the goddess be with you, Apostle. And mind the Scorpion does not sting you before you sting him.
I shall be vigilant, Mistress. Blessed be the goddess. Blessed be the path. Blessed be the word. Blessed be the mission.
I rebuke my condition. If you're a strong woman, you don't need permission. All right, this world is ruled by them ladies. But they kind of cruel, huh?
Can we trust him?
If not him, then who? He is our most faithful apostle.
He knows not to question our word. He will complete his mission.
Amen, girl.
The prophet was adamant. There is much resting on this task. It is the last obstacle, the prophet said. When it is done,
the light of the goddess will wash across the world like a tidal wave, drowning all those who lack faith. May that day come swiftly, and may the goddess aid the apostle in his mission. The future of our empire rests on his shoulders now.
That sounds epic. The prophet. Is the prophet a man or a woman? That's my question. Should we go to Cloud Ship? Alright, this is the third playable character. Am I going back here?
I am being sent to the Havens tonight, Master. A cloud ship will take me east across the ocean. I must leave with haste.
With haste? I see. Another heathen who needs converting.
There's great darkness in this world. Is it not our duty to illuminate the darkness with the light of the goddess?
We cannot make the sun rise in the dead of night, Kian. Like everyone else, we must wait for dawn.
Must we have this discussion again, Master? It seems to me you question everything I believe in.
Not so, Kian. You know I'm a man of faith. What I am questioning is our right to impose our faith on others. I've been to these eastern lands and they...
And is it not a place full of darkness and sin?
No.
Would it not be better off under the guiding light of our faith and the mercy of the goddess?
No.
What would you have me answer? There is indeed arrogance, oppression, murder, and fear in those lands. But there's also beauty, freedom, and humility. And the brightest day has the darkest shadows, Kian. Remember that.
I must depart now, Master. The cloud ship leaves the havens at first light, and my duty beckons.
Duty or no duty, do only what you yourself believe to be right, and not what others tell you is right. I'll see you when you get back. You can tell me all about the Eastlanders and how you rescued their maidens from a life of sin. May you walk with the goddess, Kian.
And the light of the goddess upon you, Master Kalman.
Master Kalman? Okay. Okay, we're back to the fridge, huh? Alkara. Okay, this is another chapter, guys.
Shakli.
Where am I?
You're still at the Friends. You don't remember?
I don't know. How did I get back here?
Back? You haven't moved all night. A couple of guests found you passed out. You were drugged.
What?
That's what it looks like. I checked the cameras, but there was nothing on them. The crystals were wiped. When we found you last night, I called a friend of mine, a doctor. She came by and checked you out. She said you were on some kind of synth, but that you'd sleep it off. So I closed the room and kept an eye on you all night.
That's not possible. I was somewhere else. April. She...
What?
I met April. April Ryan. I was in Arcadia, the place she spoke about. I was there. So I couldn't possibly have been here.
Zoe, look, I've been checking in on you every 15 minutes all night long. You couldn't have gone anywhere without me noticing. You were fed some kind of hallucinogenic. You've probably been having very vivid dreams.
Dreams are real. I mean,
That's impossible. I was there. I spoke with April. She wasn't very cooperative, but I did speak with her.
All I know is that you've been sleeping right here since we found you. You left Emma and me at the table to make a call. 20 minutes later, some guests found you passed out in the booth. They gave up their reservation quite willingly. They didn't want to get involved.
Sorry about that.
Sorry? Girl, it's not your fault that someone drugged you. But you might want to consider getting out of this before you get hurt.
I can't just abandon Reza.
I'm sure he doesn't want you to put yourself at risk like this.
Did you see whoever did this to me?
You don't remember anything?
No. Last night's a blur. The first thing I remember is waking up in... No, I don't remember anything from the Fringe.
I didn't see anyone. But apparently our friend Marcus Crozier checked in just before the incident. And he brought two guests.
Wait. I remember... part of it. Marcus. The twins.
Twins?
They're working together. They were in Reza's apartment back in Casablanca. And they were here last night.
They traveled all the way to America.
Maybe. But I don't understand why they didn't just... kill me. I mean, that's the second time they've attacked me. And I'm still walking.
If there's one thing I've learned, it's not to look a gift horse in the mouth. You're alive. Don't ask too many questions.
Maybe you're right. Maybe I should just go home while I'm still... After all, Mark has turned out to be a big mistake on my part. And if Reza's gotten himself into something really dangerous... Besides, I don't know where to go from here. I might as well head back to Casablanca and wait for Reza to get in touch with me.
That sounds like a good idea, girl. How do you feel?
A bit woozy. But pretty good, considering. Did Emma leave already?
Early this morning. She has a show later today in Moscow. I promised I'd keep her updated.
So what are you going to tell her?
In where?
I don't know. What you just told me, I guess. Who knows? Even if it was a dream, maybe you really did speak with April.
It felt real enough. I don't know. I need to sort things out in my head. Well, I guess I will go home. I don't feel like crossing paths with Marcus or the twins again.
They were probably just trying to scare you. Your friend seems to be onto a pretty big story.
Yeah. I just hope that... Ow.
You okay, Zoe?
Just my head. Yeah, I'm okay.
You can stay here as long as you need to. And I can call my doctor friend again. No need to go to a hospital.
No, I should go home. Thanks, Charlie. I really appreciate it.
No problem, girl. Drop by if you're ever in town again, and keep me updated if you find your friend or if you hear from April.
I will, Charlie. Thanks for everything.
Okay, guys. That was interesting. Should we just leave?
Hola, sweetie. It's me. Where are you?
Hi, Liv. I'm still in Newport, but I'm on my way home. Any news?
Yes. You're going to Japan.
Japan?
I decrypted Reza's notes. Well, most of them. Okay, some of them. I'm still working on it, but I found out that he was investigating Wati Corp.
Wati Corp? Really? My God, that's pretty huge. What was he investigating?
Don't know yet, sweetie, but he was in contact with two people at Wati, one of whom was the dead girl in his apartment. From his notes, my guess is that after leaving Newport, he would be heading to Wati City, on the island of Hokkaido in northern Japan. That's where Wati Corp HQ is located. That's also everything I've got so far, I'm afraid. I'll keep working on Reza's notes, and I'll have more info for you when you get there.
You mean Japan?
You know, I'd try and convince you not to go, but you seemed pretty set on tracking Reza down, and all signs point to Japan.
I know. I have to keep going. I can't give up. Not now, not this time. This is too important. If I quit...
Is everything all right, Zoe?
Yes and no. I'm fine. I'm not hurt or anything, but... things have happened. Well, I don't have time to get into it right now. But it'll make a hell of a story someday.
As long as you're okay, sweetie. Like I said, I'll keep working on the notepad, and I'll call you when you get to Wati City. Safe journey.
All right, Liv. Take care.
Apparently we're going to Japan. Okay. Okay, this is a licensed song. My favorite one. Hell yeah, guys. In 3, 2, 1, we're about to start singing this beautiful song. And look at this beautiful intro of me. I'm so excited, I just can't sleep. Oh yeah, so delighted, we should finally meet. No, 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 whoa. Always had a feeling you would show. Yeah, leave me here.
All
okay.
Right. So tell me about the tower.
It is as most things, Azadi. Large, wasteful, and arrogant. I have never seen its like. They are building a ladder to the heavens.
Maybe it's a temple of sorts. I may not know a lot about the enemy, but they're pretty religious.
To call the Azadi religious would be like calling the sun warm. Their faith is all they have. If we shake that, the war is ours.
I don't think that's a viable strategy, Chuan. But it's good to know that they have a weakness. Faith is a double-edged sword.
True.
This tower of theirs may be another weakness. When I was there earlier, I noticed they were still building. They have put up wooden platforms for the workers to climb.
Scaffolds. Next to the tower?
On the tower. If one were to climb it, one might find a way into the tower.
Perfect. I need to check it out for myself. That tower must be very important to the Azadi. And like you said, it could be another weakness of theirs.
You will go alone.
I need to. If there are more of us, it...
They might find us.
We are easier to spot. And if you are caught, someone still needs to return to the city with the supplies. That is our mission.
That's our mission, Chuan. I'll be back before dawn.
Watch your back, Raven.
Alright guys, so we're gonna finish on it for today. I actually planned to finish when we first started the chapter, but we're already like kind of 10 minutes into or something. We're gonna be playing April for the very first time, kind of very first time. We actually played her in the first episode, like just some fighting, but it's gonna be exciting.
We have to travel light, and we have to stay packed, just in case.
That kind of looks like Brian Westhouse's backpack. Anyways, that's gonna be it for today. Don't forget to drop a like, write a comment, subscribe to this channel, and I'll see y'all for the next episode. Bye!